Potato.
Live from Sydney, 7 News with Anne Sanders.
First at 4, good afternoon. Sydney's daily COVID cases have risen, with a lengthy list of new venues in Burwood joining the exposure sites in the eastern suburbs. There were 24 new infections overnight, with half of them not in isolation. They've been out in the community. Of most concern, another hospital worker testing positive. For more, let's bring in Chief Reporter Chris Reason live in the newsroom. Hi there, Chris. An aged care facility is now on high alert.
Yeah, good afternoon. And we've had 195 cases total since this outbreak began some 16 days ago. But this today is the first time we've had a case inside an aged care facility. It's the Summit Care Baulkham Hills Nursing Home. 149 residents there. The good news is 135 of them have already received their vaccines. In fact, double shots of Pfizer. So that is very positive news. The test now for those vaccines to see how effective they are. Unfortunately, the worker at the centre of this this case, though, had not received her shot at this stage. 40 to 45 staff now being told to isolate. They're awaiting test results. And for the residents themselves, well, they're now in lockdown, all of them confined to their rooms and everybody undergoing tests every 48 hours. Now, this case linked back to the case we brought you yesterday. The 24-year-old trainee nurse who worked split shifts between the Royal North Shore Hospital and the Fairfield Hospital. And they've done tests on her and her close contacts and family in these last 24 hours, and already new cases are springing up. In particular, a friend of hers and a housemate. That housemate also worked at Fairfield and Royal North Shore, and also another hospital, the Royal Ryde Hospital as well. All of that linked back, as I say, to the Summit Care Baulkham Hills. And obviously, with the memories of Newmarch and Dorothy Henderson Lodge and what happened in Victoria, authorities are on edge over this one, watching closely. So too was the management at that facility. We spoke to the Chief Operating Officer, Michelle Sloan. She's been on the phone since 1 o'clock this morning. Let's listen to her response.
It's not somewhere we want to be, clearly, but it was always possible. And we always thought it may be a staff member that would bring it in.
Chris, there are also serious concerns. COVID complacency is on the rise, with the Premier issuing some stern warnings today.
Yeah, and of the 24 new cases today, only 9 of those people were actually in isolation from the moment they started to show symptoms, doing the right thing. It turns out that 12, half of them, 12 people, were actually out and about in the community despite showing clear signs of suffering from some sort of cold or flu. That has angered the authorities, forcing them to again repeat that message that as soon as you start to display symptoms, you need to isolate and get tested. The Premier hinting today that if this sort of behaviour continues, if this sort of way of behaviour goes on into the future, we will not see this lockdown lifted as promised in a week's time. Let's take a listen to her warnings this morning.
A number of those cases were people who were conducting work in the last few days, some with symptoms, and we can't continue to have that happen.
Some good news today, though, again, Anne, we've had phenomenal testing rates overnight, almost 60,000 people lining up to 8 p.m. to get themselves tested. A growing list of venues of concerns, though we couldn't possibly read it all out here for you. You need to go to the New South Wales website to check those, but two of principal concern, Pacific Square, Shopping Centre at Maroubra, and also Auburn Central. Authorities warning anybody there to quickly get to the website, check the dates and times, and act appropriately.
All right, Chris, thank you very much. Chris Reason reporting. The state government has unveiled plans for 3 new locations where you'll be able to receive the coronavirus vaccine. 2 of those will be mass vaccine hubs, one in a former David Jones store in Wollongong, the other at an old Coles building in Macquarie Fields. The CBD will also benefit with a vaccine clinic announced. No timeline has been given as to when they'll be up and running. Queensland's top doctor has been cast out by her medical peers. They've slammed her claims young people would be putting their lives at risk if they had the AstraZeneca shot. Live to Rob Scott in Canberra. Rob, Dr. Jeanette Young's comments have been labelled extreme, but she isn't backing down.
not backing down. Instead, she's doubling down. And Dr. Yun today defended herself, insisting that what she said is true, that she doesn't want people under 40 to get the AstraZeneca jab because of the risk of death associated with a very rare blood clotting disorder. But her views aren't shared by medical leaders, who say the risk is minuscule and her remarks are adding to vaccine hesitancy.
Nearly every medical leader, Omar Khorshid of the AMA, the president of the College of GPs, myself, distanced themselves from Dr. Young's comments yesterday. She's unfortunately out on a very lonely limb there.
Dr. Young's comments are more extreme than the other states. Getting any confusing and conflicting messages is dangerous at this time.
Certainly the type of scaremongering we've seen coming from the Queensland Premier and the Queensland Chief Medical Officer don't help confidence. They do help anti-vaxxers.
Debate flared up after the Prime Minister announced the government would offer doctors legal protection to give the AstraZeneca vaccine to people under 60, in direct contrast to the official health advice. And despite the criticism today, Dr. Young is standing firm.
No, that is the truth, that there is a risk that you can die from one of those rare, and they're rare, blood clots. And the younger you are, the more likely it is it will happen. This is my advice. People, of course, can go and get their own advice.
People have a right, if we have vaccines available, in this case we have AstraZeneca available, to go to their GPs and make a decision about whether it is right for them to get the vaccine now.
And it seems they are. Since the PM made the announcement on Monday, more than 2,600 Australians under 40 have come forward to get the AstraZeneca jab. And
Rob Scott in Canberra. Thank you, Rob. Customer Service Minister Victor Dominello has accepted an apology from New South Wales Health for a bungle that has forced him back into COVID isolation. State political reporter Alex Hart joins us live after speaking with the minister a short time ago. Alex, Minister Dominello says this was all an innocent mistake.
That's right, Anne, and Victor Dominello is once again holed up inside his apartment in Sydney, where he'll be for at least the next 6 days. The customer service minister was told shortly after his media conference yesterday with the Premier that he is once again considered to be a close contact of infected colleague Adam Marshall and was rushed back into isolation. A health official had only told him on Saturday that he'd been reclassified as a casual contact based on their interaction between those two ministers in Minister Dominello's office. But what health overlooked was footage from inside the lower house chamber from Question Time, which showed Minister Dominello right in front of Minister Marshall, surrounded by other ministers and MPs who are all still in isolation. The Chief Health Officer has admitted this was a mistake and apologised to the minister, but she insists Minister Dominello never posed any threat because he has since tested negative and has not displayed any symptoms. Let's listen in.
And I regret this, but as I said, everyone was doing the best with their best intent.
Well, I don't hold any grudges. I'm not here to second guess their advice or to challenge their advice.
Well, Alex, other MPs aren't satisfied with the explanation. Why is that?
Well, and there's a bit of concern about a potential double standard here. The Chief Health Officer revealed today that she'd given out her personal mobile number to MPs and urged them to contact her if they had any questions about their personal situations. While Minister Dominello didn't do this himself, other MPs have done that. And One Nation's Mark Latham points out that the general public, of course, doesn't have this sort of access to the health bureaucracy. And the Deputy Premier has also expressed concerns about how this bungle was allowed to happen in the first place. Take a look.
It's clearly favouritism, some sort of weird political convenience that he's downgraded so he can go to a press conference. What about all the people locked up? Can't go anywhere. Doing the right thing.
I'm not going to stand aside pretend that these inconsistencies are acceptable. And I've called it out, and the public has every right to know.
Some good news, Anne. So far, none of Adam Marshall's close contacts, in Parliament at least, have tested positive.
All right, Alex. Thank you. Alex Hart reporting. Well, the forecast was right on. Sydney's had another misty morning, the fog extending even into the state's central west. Miley Hogan was, well, in the thick of it. And, Miley, it caused some inconvenience for commuters.
Good afternoon. Well, once again, Sydneysiders woke up to a thick blanket of fog. The whiteout again caused disruptions on the road with low visibility and all ferry services were cancelled. It was a little strange, though, this morning. That fog set in early, but by around 7:30, the sun had come out and started to burn some of it off. That did not last long. Around half an hour later, the fog was back and even denser than before, and ferry services were cancelled again.
I'm looking for Sydney. I can't find it anywhere. Just across the road, it used to be around there somewhere, wasn't it? Harbour Bridge, where's the tower? The new tower is gone as well.
Despite the disruption, it did make for an interesting view. Plenty of people taking advantage of that time to exercise outdoors and take in the misty outlook. The fog has been caused by yesterday's showers, high humidity and overnight cool temperatures.
To have two in a row where it's not very good visibility is quite noteworthy.
The fog hung around for quite a while. You could still see it around the top of the buildings at midday. It is expected to be clear tomorrow morning.
Thanks, Miley. Well, Angie Asimus joins us now with more weather details. Angie, once the fog cleared, it was a much more settled day.
It was, and most Sydney suburbs recorded a rain-free day, only a millimetre or less across Baulkham Hills, Merrylands, Fairfield and Lucas Heights. This is how most of the day panned out for the rest of us. After the fog, it was fine, although cloudy. A few glimpses even of blue sky in between. Not too many, though. Right now, it is partly cloudy in the CBD, 16 degrees with an apparent temperature of just 14. The focus of the wet weather, though, has shifted away from the coast to inland regions now. It started overnight, but since 9 a.m. there have been decent falls in two pockets, 31 millimetres around Coonamble and around 20 millimetres in the suburbs of Canberra. We will still see particularly heavy falls ramp up in the northeast corner. In the wake of the cold front and trough moving through, we're about to see much cooler temperatures as well. Already today, tops of 12 degrees for Young, 13 for Goulburn. The real chill, though, is due to happen over the weekend with snow forecast across the southern Alps in particular. I will have your full weekend weather forecast coming up very soon.
See you then, Angie. Thank you. Still to come in Sydney's afternoon news on 7, breaking news on the AstraZeneca blood clotting issue. Plus, Bill Cosby set free, the entertainer released from prison, his sex crimes conviction overturned. A shocking scare on the M1. We have the pictures. Remembering Diana, Harry and Will together to honour their mother, Princess Diana, on her 60th birthday. That story a little later. But first, a massive legal blow looming for the Trump Organisation. That's next.
A little bit of love to me is it's everything. Oh,
just like the air I breathe. This year, more than one farmer will find love.
Yeah, I'm definitely getting that fuzzy little feeling.
Real love is back.
New Farmer Wants a Wife starts Sunday at 7 on 7.
For over 60 years, nothing has been more effective in providing pain and fever relief than children's Panadol. They can start to reduce fever in just 15 minutes. But did you know you should calculate your child's dose by weight rather than their age? At Terry White Chemmart, they can help you calculate the correct dose of pain relief, helping your kids get back to being kids fast. Right now at Terry White Chemmart, children's Panadol is just $16.99. Children's Panadol and Terry White Chemmart. Now that's real chemistry.
If you choose to take on the family road trip and you have a covered accident, we'll cover the reasonable costs of towing to the nearest place of safety from anywhere in Australia. Choose Allianz Comprehensive Car Insurance. Allianz, behind you for what's ahead.
Looking for a way to boost your immunity? Redoxon's triple action formula helps support your immunity daily. Problem solved.
Psst. Powerball has jackpotted to $60 million. Are you keen? Well, first you have to play.
Play now in-store at thelot.com or on the Lot app.
Red Rock Deli, there's always something new to discover. Feed your curiosity.
From the moment I laid eyes on you,
what I said. I said I see it.
Great Southern Bank has the vault. It hides your home deposit. If you're tempted, it says halt. Saving for a home is no barrel of laughter. But you can make it happen. Happily clever after.
Your wellbeing and the communities is our main priority. So here's how to be a COVID-safe shopper at Woolworths.
When shopping in store, it's important to sanitise your hands and wear a mask. And please continue to practice social distancing. Shop online and you won't even need to leave your car with our Director Boot service or choose contactless delivery.
If we look out for each other and follow these steps together, we can help each other to be COVID safe when shopping at Woolworths.
Made by Australia.
To breaking news, there's an urgent COVID alert now for the vaccine super hub at Olympic Park. An infected person attended on Tuesday afternoon. Anyone who was there between 3:30 p.m. and 5 p.m. is being urged to get tested immediately and to watch out for symptoms. We have some more breaking news now. The TGA has also just released its weekly vaccine report, finding a woman vaccinated in Australia 5 weeks ago has since died in the UK. It's understood the woman received the AstraZeneca jab and had serious underlying health conditions. The TGA is investigating, but say test results suggest she had the rare clotting condition linked to the vaccine. The report also found 5 new clotting cases potentially linked to the AstraZeneca vaccine here in Australia. Authorities are doubling down, saying the clotting condition is extremely rare. Drivers on the M1 motorway in the city's southwest were given a major shock by a car driving on the wrong side of the road. A green Holden can be seen quickly changing lanes to avoid the SUV yesterday. It's unknown how long the driver was on the wrong side of the motorway at Moonee Moonee, but incredibly, no crashes were reported. Police are hoping to speak with the driver. American comedian Bill Cosby has been called a victim of the judicial system by his legal team after he walked free from jail overnight. In a stunning backflip, an appeal court overturned his landmark sexual assault conviction, claiming he wasn't given a fair trial. Our US correspondent David Woodward reports.
Good afternoon. Yes, Bill Cosby tonight back at home after this shock decision to overturn his conviction. Still, the 83-year-old is tonight maintaining his innocence. Accusers, though, furious at the development. Is Cosby's first fragile steps to freedom. The man once known as America's dad, propped up by his legal team as they address the media. Cosby, unwilling or perhaps unable, didn't say a word, leaving that to the team that secured his freedom after 2 years of a 3 to 10 year sentence.
He is extremely happy to be home. He looks forward to reuniting with his wife and his children.
The comedian later calling into a radio station.
This is for all the people who have been imprisoned wrongfully, regardless of race, color, or creed.
Mm-hmm.
Because I met them in there.
We love you, Mr. Cosby!
The court today ruled it identified a due process violation. The decision makes no claims to his innocence. This a legal technicality. But according to Andrea Constant, the woman who instigated the case with claims of sexual abuse in 2004, it does serve to discourage other women from making similar claims. Today's majority decision regarding Bill Cosby is not only disappointing but of concern in that it may discourage those who seek justice for sexual assault in the criminal justice system from reporting. Dozens of women had publicly made claims of sexual assault against Cosby, and today some expressed their extreme disappointment in the ruling.
I'm outraged. I'm infuriated.
Still, it's unlikely to change anything. Bill Cosby cannot be retried on these charges.
A grand jury in New York is believed to have indicted the Trump Organization after a long-running investigation into tax-related crimes. The former president was touring the unfinished wall on the US-Mexico border when the latest development was reported. Manhattan's district attorney is expected to lay charges in the coming hours and unseal details of the grand jury's decision. It's understood Mr. Trump is not personally charged, but that the company's chief financial officer will be. Former US Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld has died, aged 88. He played a critical role in advising President George W. Bush to invade Iraq and Afghanistan. Mr. Rumsfeld passed away surrounded by his family in New Mexico. Next in Seven's afternoon news, new COVID alerts for popular venues around Burwood, and Australia's cricket captain reveals his coach has vowed to change.
Tonight on 7 News with Mark Ferguson.
Nursing home lockdown, vaccines put to the test, Parramatta apartments shut down for serious defects, and finding COVID risk locations online.
What is this really costing you? The hidden fees on cashless payments. What are you really being charged? The Sunrise Investigation, tomorrow.
Celebrate every moment with Pandora Jewelry.
It goes lights, camera, action when I step into the limelight. Easily adapted to the highlight.
That's good food and drinks. My mood makes you think that this life's made for a king.
So many different things to do within the high.
Powerball has jackpotted to $60 million. Are you keen? Well, first you have to play.
Play now in-store at thelot.com or on the Lot app.
If you're like me and where you call home changes over time, it's good to know that Apiat has different home insurance options to choose from.
Call Apiat on 13 50 50.
Maybe we could find ways to call time out on our kids' busy routines before they get sick. But if they do, Children's Panadol can start to reduce fever in just 15 minutes. Together, let's rethink care.
You don't have to quit alone. You've got family to call on, mates to count on, and Nicorette's new spearmint gum, which acts fast and lasts. In fact, there are 141 fewer Aussie smokers each week. Now's the time to join the quitters.
Ooh la la, it's Euros time. And you can get involved with a Sportsbet same game multi. Combine all your favourite markets into one bet and get bigger odds. Make it a same game multi this Euros with Sportsbet.
Discover a new Law Limited creation made with rare yellow Arabica Catuai coffee cherries. Compatible with your Nespresso machine. Law Espresso, a masterpiece in taste.
Imagine one little thoughtful action for our planet. Done by some of us. Now imagine many little thoughtful actions done by many of us. All of us. IKEA.
Several other health facilities across Sydney are this afternoon on edge after a student nurse passed on the virus to a colleague. Royal North Shore and Fairfield hospitals are already on alert, but a rehabilitation centre in Ryde and an aged care facility in Baulkham Hills are now also potentially impacted. Several new venues have also been added to the COVID alert list, including multiple shops in Burwood, Hurstville and Petersham. time for sport now with Mel McLaughlin. And this is what every Panthers fan wanted to hear, Mel.
That's right, and it gets better and better. Nathan Cleary believes he'll be back in plenty of time for the Panthers' run to the finals. Cleary dislocated his shoulder during the Blues' Origin Series win against Queensland. Nathan and Dad Ivan are convinced Jerome Luai and Matt Burton can do the job as Penrith's halves.
I've got full confidence in the boys and I'm sure they'll show that this Friday night in a tough game against the Eels.
We'd like to think that, you know, losing any player or one or two players or whatever it is, we can get over.
All Cowboys players and staff have returned negative COVID tests. They can resume training and play against Newcastle on Sunday, but coach Todd Payton is in 14 days isolation. Aaron Finch has praised Justin Langer for taking confronting criticism of his coaching on the chin. Some Australian cricketers complained about Langer's intense style in an external review. Finch says Langer made a heartfelt promise to change before they left on their West Indies tour.
We're all behind him 100%. The way that he's coached Australia in the last couple of years since he's taken over has been fantastic.
They've arrived in the Caribbean for 5 T20s and 3 one-dayers. Nick Kyrgios never escapes drama and his first round match against Hugo Humbert at Wimbledon was no exception. Resuming at 3-all in the fifth set, Kyrgios overcame a scary fall on slippery grass to finish off the talented Frenchman 9-7.
Just got back up and showed some resilience, you know, come with age.
Jordan Thompson and James Duckworth are among 7 Aussies into the second round, playing his first Wimbledon single since 2017. Andy Murray's starting a sentimental run. The Scot came from 2-1 down to defeat German Oscar Otter. Richie Porte was 9th on the Stage 5 Tour de France time trial, trying to make up for lost time after the day one crash.
I didn't actually really come down, I just got stuck behind it, but yeah, so far so good.
Port's settled on a support role, trying to help teammate Geraint Thomas beat Slovenian gun Tadej Pogacar. The reigning champ smashed all rivals by 19 seconds to close within 8 seconds of Mathieu van der Poel's yellow jersey. The Phoenix Suns are into their first NBA finals since 1993. Chris Paul outscored the LA Clippers 27-21 on his own in the final 13 minutes of Game 6. He had 41 in the Suns' 130-103 victory to win the West. They are waiting for Milwaukee or Atlanta, who are 2-all in the East. Well, we've heard from so many Olympians about the importance of their families and parents before the Tokyo Games, but few were the emotion of Aiden Roach, the son of league legend Steve Blocker Roach, in the video unveiling the Aussie Sharks water polo squad.
Sing the national anthem.
They've done absolutely everything they can for me in life, and, you know, I hope if I have kids one day, then I can be, you know, as important to them as they are to me.
Just beautiful. Well, the Russian athletes went to the Kremlin for Vladimir Putin's blessing, then to church. 335 Russians will compete without their flag and anthem due to doping sanctions. Looks pretty intense over there. But what about Aiden Ross?
Oh, a beautiful piece.
Yep.
Yeah, really heartfelt.
Yep.
Thank you, Mel.
Thanks,
Anne. Don't go anywhere. Our top stories are just ahead. Another hospital worker infected, wards and patients on edge. Vaccine hubs coming to your suburb. Shots in Wollongong, the southwest and the CBD. More explosive AstraZeneca comments, and we show you the app which helps you avoid virus exposure sites. That's next.
What do you want from me?
The truth.
With every mystery, there's more to the story.
This job deserves another look.
And when someone vanishes, it's just the beginning.
I suggest you leave it alone.
Not a chance.
On 7 Flicks.
Tell me what you did to her.
Unravel the clues.
There's a whole lot more.
Crack the cold case. Find the person who disappeared without a trace.
We don't know where she is.
Mystery Thursdays, tonight from 7:30 on 7 Flicks.
those lights, camera action when I step into the limelight. Easily adapted to the highlight.
That's good food and drinks. My mood makes you think that this life's made for a king.
So many different things to do within the high life.
The NRMA is Australia's largest roadside assistance network.
I locked my keys in the...
There you go.
Thanks.
For a limited time, join and save $55. This is Roadside Assistance.
Got a bit of late night Euros fever? Try Sportsbet's same game multi with more markets, more offers, and bigger odds. Make it a same game multi this Euros with Sportsbet.
Take care of the big moments, like planning your finances, and make the most of the in-between moments, like this. Secure your financial well-being. Search Australian Unity.
After years of German research, now there's Body Essential Iron Vital F liquid sachets. Because it's a liquid, it's easily absorbed and gentle on the stomach. A great-tasting, organic form of iron that supports healthy immune system function with vitamin B and C. Available now.
Live from Sydney, 7 News with Anne Sanders.
Welcome back. We have some breaking news. A COVID alert has been issued for the vaccine super hub at Olympic Park. Paul Kadek is there live. Paul, take us through the latest health advice.
Good afternoon, Anne. Yes, this alert coming from New South Wales Health in just the last few minutes. And what it says is that a person who attended the vaccination hub here at Olympic Park on Tuesday between 3:30pm and 5pm has tested positive for COVID. So that is the anyone who was here on Tuesday afternoon between 3:30 and 5pm at the Olympic Park vaccine hub, someone who was also here has tested positive. The official advice from New South Wales Health is if you were here at that time in and around the hub or at the nearby P3 car park, you're being asked to monitor for any symptoms and get tested ASAP if any symptoms develop. Repeating, that is on Tuesday afternoon, 3:30 to 5pm here at the Sydney Olympic Park vaccination hub. All this as today the Premier says the state can double its rate of vaccination with the announcement of more vaccine hubs for the state, and some of them are set to open within weeks. One of them is going to be located in an old Coles supermarket building at Macquarie Fields. It'll become the mass vaccination centre for southwest Sydney and should be ready for its first patients later this month. For the Illawarra, there'll be the old David Jones department store in downtown Wollongong will be set up for vaccinations by sometime in mid-August. The state government is also finalising a clinic location in Sydney's CBD near the corner of Pitt Street and King Street, just near the Pitt Street Mall there, which will put it close to light rail and also the train stations at Wynyard and Martin Place, expected to be ready for late July, as is the hub previously announced for the Hunter region inside a former Bunnings at Lake Macquarie, all becoming operational as it's hoped more vaccine doses become available in the coming months.
We envisage that once these centres are up and running, that New South Wales Health will be able to administer up to 200,000 vaccines a week. At the moment, we're doing around 110.
Now, here at Olympic Park, they're looking at another record-breaking week with another 7,500 vaccinations done just yesterday. And tonight at 6pm, and the Sydney GP clinics getting ready to start giving out Pfizer doses from next week. And
Paul Kadek with that breaking news. Thank you very much, Paul. And that alert for Olympic Park is just the latest in a series of warnings issued today. There are also major concerns for a number of health facilities across Sydney after a student nurse infected a colleague. Live to Amber Laidler now. Amber, an aged care facility is now on alert.
Good afternoon, Anne. Yes, that's after confirmation that an unvaccinated worker at the Summit Aged Care Facility in Baulkham Hills tested positive to COVID-19. Thankfully, it is estimated 96% of the residents there have been fully vaccinated, but we've seen just how dangerous this virus can be in this setting. So the facility has been locked down and cleaning and testing is now underway. This case is linked to the 24-year-old trainee nurse who worked while infectious at the Royal North Shore and Fairfield hospitals. Two of her close contacts have also tested positive, with wards at both hospitals now locked down and more than 100 people forced into isolation. Today, New South Wales recorded 24 new cases. 12 of those were out in the community while infectious, with the Premier pleading with people to isolate immediately as soon as symptoms start to develop, even if they're incredibly mild.
Where you can, do your shopping online. Where you can, don't go to places where there's lots of other people, because the virus is still circulating in the community. And the purpose of the lockdown, if we want the lockdown to succeed, all of us have to minimise our movements. All of us have to minimise our interaction with others, as difficult as that is.
Dozens of venues have been placed on alert in the last 24 hours. Those alerts stretch right across Sydney. There are multiple for Westfield at Burwood and multiple for the East Gardens Westfield here. Another shopping complex, Pacific Square, just around the corner, has also been placed on alert. So the testing facility at Heffron Park in Maroubra was inundated with people today. Hundreds are coming forward to get swabbed. We saw almost 60,000 tests conducted yesterday. The Premier saying we need to see those numbers remain high as we try to get on top of this outbreak, Anne.
All right, Amber, thank you very much. The debate over the AstraZeneca vaccine continues to rage. Doctors and politicians lined up this morning to condemn Queensland's chief health officer after she urged young people to steer clear of the jab.
Nearly every medical leader, Omar Korshid of the AMA, the president of the College of GPs, myself, distanced themselves from Dr. Young's comments yesterday. She's unfortunately out on a very lonely limb there.
All right, let's bring in Joel Dry now, live in Queensland. Joel, far from softening her position, Dr. Young doubled down today.
She did. Despite the criticism, she remains very firm on this, Anne, to the point where she actually got quite frustrated today in this morning's press conference. Dr. Young said she's been given the best possible advice over these past 18 months, and that advice from her still remains that people under the age of 40 should not get the AstraZeneca jab. She believes the risk of young people getting a blood clot and possibly dying is enough to warrant waiting for the Pfizer vaccine to become more broadly available. Dr. Young was pushed on whether that advice would cause confusion and slow the rollout, and this was her pretty stern response.
I am on the record as supporting vaccination, but I want the right vaccine to go to the right person. Please, can I just stop all this? This is getting absolutely silly. So I've put my advice out there very, very clearly. Now, people need to work out where they want to get advice from.
Another bit of her advice that Queenslanders are hanging on is whether the current three-day lockdown will end tomorrow. Overnight, we had two new locally acquired cases, but none of them linked to the Delta outbreak from the Prince Charles Hospital that has been cause of great concern. The Chief Health Officer said the signs are encouraging, but she'll wait till tomorrow to make a call on the lockdown.
All right, good luck tomorrow, Joel. Thank you. Return traveller Gillian Hannah was stuck in a Sydney hotel in quarantine when her father passed away in a Melbourne hospital this morning. She's one of many people who are seeking an exemption from the 14-day confinement, some of them with more luck than others. Amelia Brace reports.
Well, this is yet another heartbreaking story of someone stuck in hotel quarantine, unable to farewell a loved one. Gillian Hanna raced back to Australia from the US last month after being told her father's lungs were shutting down.
I just FaceTimed him. He's on a lot of medication and he sort of knew who I was, but, you know, was a little bit vague. I said what I needed to say and, you know, that's the last moment, so get with him.
Gillian is fully vaccinated and has tested negative for COVID-19 twice since returning to Australia. Despite that, she's been denied a compassionate exemption and told she would need to charter a plane to travel to Victoria so she doesn't come into contact with the general community.
I don't have $10,000 just lying around, and I asked if I was able to drive down and they said absolutely not, we would never approve that.
Her story is remarkably similar to that of Anna Coffey, who has been granted an exemption to travel to Melbourne to see her dying dad.
I'm just going to be feeling so happy, so overwhelmed at that moment. I really just cannot wait.
Anna was finally reunited with her father today. He too has just days to live. New South Wales Health says it tries to show compassion in all cases, but it's simply being overwhelmed by all these requests, given so many people from other states are quarantining here in Sydney.
Thanks, Amelia. On a day the Premier has urged us all to minimise our movements outside of the house, there's a new online tool that will help you avoid exposure sites when you do have to leave home for essential reasons. All the COVID exposure sites across the country are now listed on one source, as Consumer Affairs Editor Helen Wellings explains.
Australian researchers have developed a solution for keeping up with COVID hotspots as they happen around the nation. And it's a great device to use before you go shopping or travel anywhere. Knowing exactly when and where COVID outbreaks happen near you, anywhere nationally, can be nigh impossible. Today, the launch of a new contact tracing tool, easily accessible maps on your iPhone, PC, laptop, showing no-go risk areas.
So these are the places that infected people have been to. So you can scroll around and have a look and see what's happening near where you are.
Called CRISPR, the map is interactive. You can zoom into hotspot zones, even specific addresses and venues, with data and warnings on current outbreaks as they happen.
Sourced from hospitals, the government, health departments, and it brings all of that data together into one place.
You can also receive alerts, like during the bushfires.
It will send you a report of any changes in the situation, any new cases.
The map is updated every hour, showing locations of new outbreaks. It's available on the web from today.
Thanks, Helen. Just ahead in 7 News, the last financial year delivered families some of the biggest property gains in living memory. But what will happen now? We speak to the experts. Back to the future, flying cars are here. This is the real deal, taking off at an airport in Europe. And it's 14 degrees in Parramatta, and you will have Sydney's forecast soon.
I've done something so stupid. I slept with Sienna.
Your girlfriend's here.
You don't own him.
You're right.
Leave Bella out of this.
If you keep playing the game, I'll do it yourself. This is holding me,
holding me. You have to tell Bella.
I wish I didn't have to tell her the one thing that would tear us apart.
Bella, something happened.
Home and Away, tonight at 7 on 7.
Ben and Jerry's Topped. Discover delicious chocolatey fudge topping, then dig in to uncover even more with swirls of salted caramel and chocolate fudge brownies. Ben and Jerry's Topped. Layered with goodness from top to bottom.
It's Saturday afternoon and Dale Proctor's come in with what he calls a bung knee. Pharmacist Frank knows it's arthritis because he's got it too. Expert training and genuine understanding. Now that's real chemistry at Terry White Chemmart.
The NRMA is Australia's largest roadside assistance network.
I locked my keys in the...
There you go.
Thanks.
For a limited time, join and save $55. This is Roadside Assistance.
Don't know what's going to happen. That's why it's so fun.
Get well sooner with Blackmores BioC.
Not all mattresses are the same. We refine and tune time and time again. Because it's what's inside that counts. And that's what makes it clearly a Sealy.
At Light and Easy, we believe the secret to aging well is eating well. It's why we partner with home care package providers so that older Australians can have affordable access to healthy, delicious meals in their own home. And it's why we've introduced our new range of My Choice meals. My Choice are smaller meals designed for people who have a reduced appetite or find it difficult to eat normal-sized meals. They provide the same energy and protein as our standard dinner meals, but in a smaller portion, making them easier to finish.
With Light and Easy now, I'm getting the nutrition that I've got to have to live a better life.
Plus, home care package recipients could save 70% off the cost of their meals.
And because it's subsidised by home care package, it makes it very affordable.
If you or someone you care for could benefit from Light and Easy's award-winning healthy meal delivery service, Visit lightandeasy.com.au or call us on 13 15 12.
Is it the thrill of the chase?
Oh, such a lucky break.
That make this unmissable.
Didgeridoo, Carlos.
The Chase, weekdays at 5.
Flying cars create images of the future, and it appears the future is here. Designers in Slovakia have successfully flown a prototype between two airports. Known as the air car, it can transform itself from road vehicle to aircraft in just under 3 minutes. There'll be more safety checks before it goes commercial. You're watching 7's Afternoon News live across Sydney. Still to come, breaking the ice, Harry to meet Will, the princes honouring Diana on what would have been her 60th birthday. That story in just a minute. It's a new financial year, but the last one was a cracker for the share market, superannuation and property, all hitting double-digit highs, especially residential dwellings, as finance editor Gemma Acton reports.
Good afternoon. A little over a year ago, some economists were forecasting house price falls of as much as 30%. Today, those fears have evaporated, with home values once again hitting record highs. In the past year, both Sydney and Hobart notched up annual house price growth of more than 19%. Brisbane and Adelaide around 15%, Perth 10%, and Melbourne just under 9%. An ongoing lack of properties available for sale and record low mortgage rates have supported the market.
Alongside those low mortgage rates, we've seen a very swift economic recovery, a tighter labour force, household savings that were accumulated through restrictive periods that are now being spent on larger goods like vehicles and housing.
But while no imminent rise in interest rates is on the cards, other speed bumps are slowing down the recent runaway growth.
The difference now is that we're coming up against affordability constraints. So already we're seeing a bit of the heat coming out of the housing market and monthly growth rates starting to slow down.
Another important bucket of wealth for Australians, our retirement savings, has also had a strong 12 months. With the ASX up 24%, the median balance super fund returned 17.5%, making it the second best year for super returns on record.
Thanks, Gemma. Sydney's 6pm news is coming up with Mark Ferguson. Hi there, Mark. What's the latest from the newsroom?
Yeah, good afternoon, Anne. Again, there's plenty to cover on the rapidly evolving COVID crisis, with more blood clots and a death likely linked to the AstraZeneca shot. As the fight rages over the controversial vaccine, news today that Sydney is set for more hubs to help double the number of Pfizer jabs. Sydney's outbreak continues to grow. A nursing home in Baulkham Hills is now under lockdown after a worker linked to that infected student nurse tested positive. Also tonight, we'll speak to the driver caught in the path of a speeding SUV as it careered the wrong way down the M1. The dangerous driving didn't end there. Full details tonight at 6. The crackdown on crumbling buildings, where there are serious defects, are found at brand new Sydney properties. Owners and tenants told they can't move in. And as we've just heard, it's July the 1st, the new financial year, bringing changes to tolls, fares, tax and superannuation that are going to have a big impact on your hip pocket. We'll let you know what to expect. And all those details and much more, 7 News tonight at 6 o'clock.
See you then, Fergo. Thank you. Just ahead, commemorating Princess Diana. But first, a quick check on Sydney's traffic.
Good afternoon, Andrew Pinamo here in these days. Traffic chopper with a check on the roads. It's a good run through Eastern Creek on the M7 southbound, much the same through Moorbank on the M5 if you're tracking west towards the M7. In Ermington, there's an accident on Victoria Road southbound at Kissing Point Road. We're just hovering over it now. It's taken out the left lane, not causing major delays though. Whenever we're allowed to travel again, Stays will be here waiting. Download the Stays app for your next holiday for when the time is ready to get away together. Your together awaits.
After serving his isolation period at Frogmore Cottage, Prince Harry has joined singer Ed Sheeran to surprise children at a charity awards afternoon. The Duke is preparing to reunite with brother Prince William on what would have been their mother Princess Diana's 60th birthday. Together, they'll unveil a statue in her honour, despite the recent strain on their relationship. Europe Bureau Chief Hugh Whitfeld reports.
The feuding brothers will come face to face at Kensington Palace, where, of course, they grew up, Diana essentially a single mother. They'll unveil a statue in her honour 4 years after it was commissioned.
From kindergarten assistant to the people's princess, Diana was thrust onto the world stage at just 20 years of age when she married Prince Charles. It was a fairy tale wedding that would eventually end in a nightmare separation, but not before Diana changed the royal family forever. Diana's greatest joy came from her sons, Princes William and Harry.
The best lesson that I learned from her is be yourself. Be yourself in everything that you do, and just give as much as you can.
After leaving the royal family, Diana became an international icon in her own right, admired for her style and her dedication to charity.
HIV does not make people dangerous to know, so you can shake their hands and give them a hug. Heaven knows they need it.
Diana was constantly hounded by the press, and it ultimately led to her death.
It appears to be official. Princess Diana, at the age of 36, has died of massive internal injuries.
Princess Diana was just 36 years old. The outpouring of grief was like nothing ever seen before.
I wonder every single day what it would be like having her around.
I still feel that love. I still feel that warmth 20 years on, which is, you know, a huge testament to her.
Today would have been Diana's 60th birthday. To celebrate their mother's legacy, Princes William and Harry will unveil a statue of the Princess of Wales in the sunken garden of Kensington Palace, reportedly one of Diana's favourite spots here at what was her London home. And Diana's sons, recently divided by a family feud, will be reunited by their mother's legacy of love.
Next in Seven's Afternoon News, Angie Asimus will be here with your latest weather forecast.
It's a history-making weekend of footy when legendary Sean Burgoyne plays his 400th game.
S-I-L-K.
Come and witness history Saturday night, the Hawks up against Port. But first, the Hunters have become the Hunted.
A lot of trouble here.
Is this the end of Richmond's premiership run? The Suns are ready to beat up the wounded Tigers. Then,
Cats fans, get out of your seat.
Can Geelong claw back to the top and crush Essendon's final hopes? The history-making weekend of footy starts tonight on 7Mate.
If you're struggling to balance work, life and family, you need to shake it up. Ensure Health Shakes help you get the nutrition you need to help your body build strength from within, with a prebiotic and antioxidants to support a healthy immune system, calcium and protein for muscle and bone health. Put more balance in your work-life balance. Shake it up with Ensure.
10 minutes either
careful,
side.
Keith, do it. It's on fire.
Not all the action happens at the stadium, eh, Keith? Luckily, when accidents happen, Amy can help cover it. Who helps cover the challenges of the everyday arena? Amy does.
New Naturally Good Anti-Age, with 99% naturally derived ingredients, plus 1% for stability and safety, with organic burdock extract, visibly reduces wrinkles in 2 weeks. 100% transparency for 100% trust.
Get the jug that fills itself. Samsung fridges with autofill jug. I'm making that curve.
Check out the sticker. The Zespri sticker of sweetness.
Why are they so excited?
Something about being surprisingly sweet.
Say it slowly.
Get ready for sweetness.
Now with passion. So much delicious sweetness. It's crazy, crazy tasty.
Zespri.
The Sleeping Duck Mac 2 mattress. Sleep to live better.
Is it the thrill of the chase?
Oh! Whoa.
That was such a lucky break.
Or is it a game that pushes them to the limits of their knowledge that make this unmissable?
Didgeridoo. Fencing.
Match.
Greece.
Palace.
The Chase. Weekdays at 5.
This weather report brought to you by Bridgestone Select for tyres and car servicing.
Angie's back with the weather forecast. How's it looking, Angie?
And we might see a light shower or two tonight, but from tomorrow we enter a much more settled period, even some long sunny breaks in the days ahead. Today the city's low was 10.9 degrees, a top of 17.7, and no showers in the CBD so far. On the satellite image, you'll see onshore winds driving continued wet weather onto the coast. There's also a developing trough over northwestern New South Wales and lots of cloud cover as a result. Tomorrow, those winds will feed into the trough, causing wet weather to ramp up. Falls are likely to be heaviest in the state's northeast here. Around the nation, Brisbane will be impacted by that system with rain at times, 21 degrees. Then we go down to Canberra, Melbourne and Adelaide with more showers forecast. It will be fine, although overcast for Hobart, Perth and Darwin staying nice and settled. Back in Sydney, tomorrow will be partly cloudy, a low of 11 degrees, top of 19 with light winds. To the week ahead though, it starts to get a little bit chilly. Saturday, no significant change to the weather pattern. It will be fine with a temperature range of 9 to 19 degrees. Sunday, though, brings a lot of sunshine and cooler temperatures. Same on Monday with lows of 7 in the city and 4 in our west, tops not making it past 17 degrees. Then much cooler from there on in for our west, dipping to 3 degrees. Looking very wintry in the days ahead, Anne.
All right, we'll have to rug up. Thank you very much, Angie. And that is City's 4pm news for this Thursday. Mark Ferguson will bring you 7 news at 6 o'clock. I'm Anne Sanders. Stay with 7 now for The Chase Australia. Thanks for joining us. Have a great night.